it's Lucy and Jeff going for walks and talks, talk about banksters and Bitcoin and the apocalypse and stuff. It's Lucy and Jeff and tacos and kisses.
How you doing today, Lucy? Well, pretty good, just going for my walks. Did you hear Satan Claus and Killgates are in Davos? Oh, those are guys who want to take away my tacos. They want to make me eat lab-grown tacos. Well, they can go pound tacos. I'm just going to go for my walks, eat my tacos, and give them my cashes. Just going for a walk with Lucy. It's not too bad. Not too hot. Get a little dark. Hopefully we can finish this up and get back in time for some tacos. Well, actually, maybe I'll lead off with Doug Casey, because if you don't know his channel, he's of course on dollarvigilante.tv. He's still on YouTube somehow. And he's really like the godfather, in my opinion, of my type of worldview. Not to say it's the right worldview, but like, for example, I'll give you an example. Like, spiritually, I can't listen to too many people. You know, a lot of the preacher types who are like, you know, we're going to read this verse from the Bible. And I'm like, who wrote the Bible? They're like, God. I'm like, it's not really possible. Plus, there's lots of evidence. You know, they had the whole meeting there. Well, even that I don't believe. 1,000 years ago and, you know, King James and all this stuff. So anyway, I can't listen to your average person because they go like this deep on anything. And within seconds, I'm like, that never happened. There's no proof that ever happened. And they're like, just believe it. It's in the book. I've never really been that kind of guy. Not to say that everything in the Bible is wrong or bad or anything, but, you know, like my wife's pretty big into a lot of that kind of stuff. Less and less like the official church stuff, but she used to be into the official church stuff a bit. She at least liked going every Sunday, and, you know, to her it was like a family thing, and we'd go and we'd like, you know, just, you know, get into the God mode for a bit. And that was fine. But all the preachers, I'm like, you're an idiot. So anyway, my point is, like, for spiritual stuff, there's not many people I can listen to, but there's one I can listen to all day long. And it's Shunyamurti of Sat Yoga. And the reason is because he, like, thinks the way I think. And I'm not saying he's right because he thinks the way I think, but I totally vibe with it. I'm like, this guy's thinking on the level that I'm thinking on. And actually way higher. And that's why I listen, because why would I listen if I knew all this stuff, right? Like, he actually knows stuff I don't. And he thinks on a level that, like, I'm like, okay. Like, he's really, like, he talks about the lethal injections and how this is actually the apocalypse. But he calls it the ending of Kali Yuga, which actually makes a lot more sense of all the religion stuff, is the Vedic stuff. That's the only one that's ever really, I'm like, okay, this might be the real one, or at least closer to it. At the end of the day, it's all just a big video game anyway, right? But, so my point is, there's not many people I can really listen to. I'm trying to think off the top of my head who I really listen to on important topics. So for spirituality stuff, it's Sat Yoga and Shunyamurti. If I listen to anyone else, it's people like, not that many really. Like, I do like Eckhart Tolle's books, but it's like 1% of what Shunyamurti talks about. It's just about being present and all that, and that's great. Then, you know, business stuff, like, who do I listen to? Not Peter Schill, right? Like, not that he's not right on some things. He's actually right on a lot of the stuff he talks about the Federal Reserve, which is interesting because his family founded the Federal Reserve. But he's quite wrong on Bitcoin, in my opinion. Oh, that's sort of my point on the shooting, actually. I'm going to get into that. But before I get into that, I was sort of on another diatribe about how I don't have that many people I listen to. Like I was saying, business, finance, it's obviously everyone at the Dollar Vigilante and the Crypto Vigilante. And the reason I work with those guys is because they're all my kind of people. They think in ways that I think. And again, not that we're all right, but I can't listen to anyone else because, like, it's so, like, if you watch, like, CNBC, it's like 0.1% of what you really need to know. And it's usually wrong. It's usually Jim Cramer. Like, you know, he'll be interviewing, like, a total fraudster and like gloating and gushing and acting like a little schoolboy. Like, that's what you get on CNBC.
I regard you as a visionary next generation person. Is this the kind of ridiculous pressure that nobody needs?
You know, Steve Jobs was, I don't think there is another Steve Jobs. He was a phenomenal entrepreneur. We've got an incredible opportunity to try to uphold a legacy in Silicon Valley of changing the world.
So yeah, I can't listen to Jim Cramer and Peter Schill's like, Bitcoin's a tulip bulb. It's like, no, it's not. It's just not, okay? And not that the crypto market's been doing great, it's been doing horrible, but it's also something that, you know, happens all the time in crypto. Like, I was thinking about that the other day, like, cryptos are even down way further than where they were before. Oh, I think I'll leave it there. Lucy's attacking a security guard down there. Lucy, Ben, Lucy. Lucy. But yeah, this could be wild. So get prepared, sign up to our stuff. You know, this is all we talk about is how to prepare for this. This is the whole point of the Dollar Vigilante. I don't know how we nailed it so much, but we did. And you can get just our basic stuff, which is like 100 pages a month of stuff, plus access to all our communities, all our groups, everything, dollarvigilante.com/subscribe. And as I said, the crypto markets have been crashing, but you want to get the best advice for that. Get the Crypto Vigilante. They said Luna was going to do that. Like, oh man, it's hilarious all the things. I recommended Bitcoin at $3 in 2011. No one ever mentioned it ever again after that. I was the first person on CNBC talking about Bitcoin. They kicked me off because I started saying the Federal Reserve's a scam.
It's just math, so you can't actually
You cannot shut it down.
No.
It has no center of gravity. It has no headquarters. You can't shut it down.
The only way you could is to shut off the internet.
And then Mr. Z of TCV says, like, 2 months before one of the biggest collapses in history in the crypto market, he says that's going to happen. No one talks about it. Everyone's like, what's Peter Schill got to say? Oh, what's Pompliano saying? Let's turn on Max Kaiser. They know what's going on. Nah, they don't really. But anyway, that's fine, though, actually. It's great that most people don't know this information, so you can really profit from it. So subscribe, dollarvigilante.com/subscribe. I don't think you're going to regret it. And I think I'll leave it there. Yeah, that was enough for one video. I think we kept it under an hour, Lucy. Oh, there you are, Lucy. What were you doing? Oh, there's a security guard down there. I was just, you know, biting his ankles a little bit, just letting him know who's the boss around here. And he didn't give me any tacos, too. If he would have gave me some tacos, I would have given him some crushers. But he didn't give me any tacos, so good thing he had his ankle guards on.
Broke ankle!
Well, looks like we got some chicharrón today. Don't mind if I do. You can go ahead first, Cielo. Let me know if it's any good. Oh, Lucky, you can have a little bit too. You're pretty small. And don't forget about me. Teach your own, please. Oh, that's the good stuff. I'm gonna go over here and have some. And then I'll give her, oh, there's Lucky. Oh, Lucky wants a bit more. And then we'll give everyone crushers.